Friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. It's that time of the year where every student will be worried about his or her exam, because within 2 to 3 months all the board exams and competitive exams are going to begin. So in this particular video, let's see all the tips where you can easily score good marks in your particular exam. Okay, so coming to first important tip, prepare from your previous year's papers also. Why? Because every year we can observe that 60 to 70% of the questions will be repeating from previous years. So if you start preparing from last 5 to 6 years previous question papers, you can easily score very good marks. This is my first tip, which is most important tip. Okay. So now let's see what is the second tip. Coming to the second tip, compete with yourself. For example, if you get in the first term, if you get 60% in your second internal term, if you get 65%, target that you need to get at least 70% or above 70% in the main exam. Okay, you need to compete with yourself. You need to start improving your performance. Okay, so always target to improve your performance. Don't compare with any other person, just compete with yourself and target on increasing your score. Okay, so the next tip is time management. Time management is very important, not just for the exams, it is also very important for your preparation. Okay, so if, for example, let's think you have 1 month of your preparationary holidays. Okay, if you have preparation holidays, what you need to do is start your studies or revision from morning 5. Study 2 hours, take break, study 2 hours, take break, study 2 hours, take break. Like that, you have to manage every day, okay? And you also have to concentrate on all the subjects. Continuously, nobody can study single subject whole day, okay? You need to shift within the subjects and within the concepts. Start reading different subjects every day. Start reading different questions and topics every day, so that you will also not feel monotony and you can easily utilize your time, okay? So next tip is focus on mathematics kind of subjects. Okay, why I am especially telling you focus mostly on mathematics kinds of subjects because coming to languages or coming to any other subjects, they may cut your marks. Okay, if you really make a minute mistake also, they may cut half or one mark. But coming to mathematics, if you solve everything correctly, step by step procedure, by following the step by step procedure, you're surely gonna get 100 out of 100. So don't ignore the subjects like mathematics, which will give you full on full marks. Okay, next important tip is focus on important topics and focus on important concepts. While preparation, our trainers or our teachers, our lecturers, anybody who else it might be, they'll be telling this particular topic is very important. This particular answer will come in the exam. Okay, so all those topics or all those concepts you must prepare, so that once you concentrate on the important topics, you can easily score good marks in your exam. Next topic is write the content based on your marks. What does this mean? See, for example, in exam, if they are asking you question for 2 marks, just like write 4 to 5 lines for it. Okay, if you are asked to write the same question for 5 marks, at least write 1 page. If you are asked the same question for 10 or 12 marks, write the same question for more than 1.5 pages or 2 pages. So, based upon the marks, you should decide how much content you need to write on the question paper. Okay. And next important tip is don't repeat the same mistakes. What does this mean? It means For example, in your term exams or in your mid exams or in your quarterly or half yearly exams, in exams or in you might be doing some mistakes, okay? It may be any mistakes, okay? Try not to repeat them in your final exams. For example, in your quarterly or half yearly exam, you wrote only one line answer for your 2 marks. This is one mistake, okay? So make sure you don't repeat it in your final exam. At least you need to write 4 to 5 lines for 2 marks answers also in your final exam, okay? So try not to repeat the similar kinds of mistakes, okay? Next tip is concentrate on your weak subjects. For example, if we think we have 6 to 7 subjects, out of 6 to 7 subjects, we might be not so good in 1 or 2 subjects, okay? So don't worry about that subject. You need to pay extra attention and you need to concentrate more on such kind of subjects, okay? And next important tip is presentation matters. What does this mean? Presentation means in board or any kind of competitive exams, you need to present really well. Your handwriting should be good. You have to draw lines in the borders. You have to highlight, coming to the subjects like mathematics, you have to highlight the solution in a, like the final solution in a box. And if it is the subjects which have diagrams, you have to draw a diagram with a pencil and neatly write all its parts, like mention its parts in black or blue pen, and write the headings with different color and draw the lines after completion of your answers. All these are called presentation skills, okay? These will really improve your performance and this will really make the examiner give you full on full marks, okay? So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and also don't forget to hit this bell icon which is beside subscribe button so that you will be notified whenever I make a video. Thank you so much for watching, and last but not least, please do follow me. Please do follow my posts. Like on YouTube, I make posts and I'll upload it every single week. Okay, so if you wanted to buy mini projects, major projects or any other projects for the least cost, don't forget to comment in the comment section below, and in the description below I have given all the details regarding that. So last but not least, all the very best for your exam. See you in my next video. Bye bye. If you have any queries, do let me know in the comment section below. See you in my next video.